everyone. Thanks for coming to my video. My name is Daniela. If you watched my last video, which was like 2 months ago, I made a video of the steps leading up to my first interview and a few details after it. I wanted to touch on that a little more and explain more of that to lead into this video. If you're reading the title of this video, you'll see that I did not get that job. So I just wanted to talk about it, talk about why I think I didn't get it, etc., and give a little advice. So just recapping a little, I had an interview in the beginning of, it would have been the end of January, and it was for a new grad program. First interview was good. They asked me what floor I preferred to be on. I explained that I liked OB, anything women's health, peds, anything like that, but I'd be happy to do any floor. So I figured that was the best answer that I could give, and I think that's where I really screwed myself. I was being honest with them, which I still think is the right thing to do, but I think I should have, well, I'll get into that. So anyway, I had that interview. My next interview was a big, they were supposed to be like speed dating interviews with the different floors. But when I got there, I realized that I was the only person that only had one interview. So they were only letting me interview for labor and delivery, which I was like, well, that's fine. If I get this job, then I'll get the job that I want. But I was upset that I didn't get to interview for positions that I had even done in nursing school and that I liked in nursing school. And I just felt like I wasn't getting the opportunity that everybody else was. The director of the program said that she did everything that she did very specifically, and if you only got a certain amount of interviews, it's because she wanted you to start out in a position that you love rather than switching floors within a few months or something like that. I understand that, but I also don't know if it's really her call to say, I think you're gonna switch floors from this. I get it, don't get me wrong. But I also think, in my opinion, they lost out on a good nurse. A nurse that they're not going to have to pay to get her bachelor's later on and all of that. I interviewed for the labor and delivery position. They said, basically, it's yours. But the problem is, they didn't have it actually approved yet by the hospital, the new position. And they said, as soon as it was approved, if it did get approved, it would go internal first. I feel like I was kind of set up to fail from the beginning because I only got to interview for the one floor and it wasn't even a real position. So that pissed me off, to be honest, but everything happens for a reason, so it's okay. I think what I mainly wanted to talk about was what I could have done better to help me get a job there anyway. What I should have done rather than came in there saying, like, I love women's health, I love pediatrics, anything like that. I still would have said that, but I would have been prepared to say the other floors that I'm interested rather than I'd love to do anything else that you see fit for me. I thought that would be a good thing to say. They know that I'm willing to do anything. I'm happy to be at that hospital, all of that, but that nursing recruiter didn't want that. She wanted you to be on the same floor as long as possible. She didn't want somebody who was going to maybe transition, which again, I don't really know if that's her call. How does she know that I'm not gonna end up loving a cardiac floor or something like that? And she, in my interview, she even said, you know, I always thought I was gonna be a peds nurse, and then I was an oncology nurse for over 6 years, and sometimes you just don't know your passion. I'm like, I completely agree. I could end up getting on a floor that I never knew I'd like, and I'd probably stay on there forever, but I just, you know, need to get my foot in the door. I didn't say it as unprofessional as that, but that's a point that I was trying to get across. That frustrated me, but it did teach me to just be more prepared than I was, so I should have said, my passions lie within women's health, OB, peds, anything like that. But if that is not an option, I'd love to be on a cardiac tele floor. I love oncology. I love, you know, ICU, step down ICU, something like that. Rather than just saying, I'll do whatever you want. So that's where I went wrong. As much as that really sucked, I really think it was for the best because I was offered a position at the hospital in the town that I live, only, you know, 10 minutes from my house rather than half an hour. And with the snow in the winter and just eventually when I have kids, I don't know if I'm gonna wanna be driving that far. So I think it was a blessing in the end. It did teach me, and I hope that will teach you to just be prepared and don't go in so confident. I felt like I had really prepared for that interview. I answered all of the questions well, but just that specific part, I think, is what really messed me up. So, word of advice, be more prepared than I was. If you're going into a new grad program that doesn't have a specific floor that you're going on, give specific times that you like to be on this floor and why you think you would be good on this floor and why, rather than just saying, I'll do whatever else you got, because that's where I went wrong, and that's what I want to save other people from. Even though it still turned out well, I could have been working for the past 2 months rather than just applying for more jobs. So in the long run, I don't think it's really going to matter. But for the short amount of time, how, like, 2 months of working could be like $10,000. So, you know, it's whatever. I hope you like this video. If it helped you out, give it a like. Give it a comment. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks.